Hello everyone, welcome back to part 18 of our Endless Runner tutorial series. Today, we're going to add moving obstacles like cars. You can use anything, but for this tutorial, I'll be adding moving vehicles. Now, let's get started. I'm using vehicles for moving obstacles, so for the vehicle models, I'm using the vehicle variety pack from the Unreal Engine Marketplace. It's a free asset, and you can use the same if you want to. I'm specifically using the vehicle variety pack, not the vehicle variety pack volume, but you can use either. If you're using Unreal Engine versions 5.0, 5.1, and 5.2 and want to use the vehicle variety pack like me, it's not available for those versions mentioned, but you can still use it. To add it to your project, click on Add to Project. If you can't see your project in the projects list, enable Show All Projects. It will now also show incompatible projects. Select your project and in the bottom left side, if the asset is not compatible with your engine version, just select 4.27 from the select version and add to project. Once imported, open your project. You can find the vehicle meshes in the content browser, under Vehicle Variety Pack folder, then Meshes folder. For this tutorial, I will be using two vehicles, sports car and hatchback. If you have your own models, you can use them too. This method will also work for other moving obstacles and not just vehicles. Once you have opened your project in Unreal Engine, go to the Runner folder, then Blueprints, and Open Obstacles folder. Right-click on BP underscore obstacle and create a child blueprint class, name it BP underscore car 1. Open it. Select the static mesh from the components tab. From the drop-down, choose your vehicle model. Set the scale to 1.1 in all axes and rotate it 180 degrees in the Z-axis. Set the Z-axis location to 25. From the Component tab, add Box Collision. From the Details tab, set the scale of the box collision so that it covers the entire obstacle. Also, increase the height accordingly. Select the box collision and duplicate it. Set its x-axis scale to 125, y-axis to 50, and z-axis to 10. Also, move the box collision in the x-axis so that the back of the obstacle and the other end of the box collision are closer like I did. When the player overlaps this large box collision, the obstacle moves towards the player. Now, from the Components tab, add an arrow, rotate it 180 degrees in the Z-axis and move the arrow in the X-axis to the other end of the box collision. I recommend you move the arrow a little far away from the box collision like I did. Compile and save. I've added the arrow as a location reference for the obstacle to move to. In the Components tab, you can rename the box collisions to avoid confusion. Go to the event graph and select the small box collision covering the obstacle. In the Details tab, scroll down to Events and create an On Component Begin Overlap event. From the Other Actor pin, add Cast a BP underscore Runner character. As Runner character, add the Death function and then add a delay, set the delay to 1 second. After the delay, add set game paused and enable paused. Now, from the Components tab, select the large box collision and create an on component begin overlap event. From the Other Actor pin, add cast a runner character. Then, if you want to use any sound for the obstacle when it is moving, you can add a play sound attached node. From the Components tab, drag and drop the component that you want to attach the sound to the Attach to Component pin. Also, choose the sound from the dropdown. Currently, I don't have any sounds, so I will remove the node. So from the Cast to Runner Character node, add a Timeline node. Change the pin from Play to Play from Start. Double-click on the node to open the timeline. Click on Add Track button and add a Float Track. Rename the track to Move Obstacle. Also, set the length to 90. Right-click on the graph and add a key. Set the time and value to 0. Add another key and set its value to 1 and time to 90. You can change the length and time to adjust the speed of the moving obstacle. From the Update pin, add Set World Location, Static Mesh. From the Components tab, drag and drop the arrow from it, add Get World Location. From it, add Break Vector, then add Lurk node. Now, change the X pin connected to Lurk from A to B. Duplicate the Get World Location and Break Vector nodes, and connect the Static Mesh node to the target pin of Get World Location. And now connect the X pin of the Break Vector node connected to Static Mesh node to A pin of the Lurk node. Now add a Make Vector node and connect the Y and Z pins of Break Vector node to Y and Z pins of Make Vector node. And disconnect the X pin from Make Vector node. Connect the Move Obstacles Float pin of Timeline node to Alpha pin of Lurk node, and connect Lurk return value to X pin of Make Vector node. Now connect the return value of Make Vector node to new location pin of Set World Location. Finally, from the finished pin of the timeline node, add a delay node and set the delay to 5 seconds. From it, add destroy actor. Go to viewport, in components tab select the small box collision covering the car and drop it inside the static mesh so that the box collision moves with the obstacle. Compile and save. Now to make another moving obstacle, just duplicate this one and replace the static mesh and adjust box collision scale if needed. Now to make them spawn, go to content browser and open bp_floor. Create a new function called spawn moving obstacles, but here I am naming the function spawn cars as I'm using vehicles as moving obstacles. Also open bp_runner game mode. Go to add floor function and from the last node of the function, add an increment node. From the integer pin, promote it to a variable and name it floor count for obstacles. From the execution pin of the increment node, add set floor count for obstacles, and connect the integer pins if they are not connected. Compile and save. Now, go back to bp_floor, then go to spawn moving obstacles function, near the function add get game mode, from it add cast to runner game mode. as runner game mode add floor count for obstacles from an add greater than node. From the secondary value of the greater than node add random integer in range. And set the minimum value to 15 and max value to 20 or 25. From the Boolean pin of the greater than node add branch node, and connect its execution pin with cast to runner game mode. If you have more than one obstacle, from true pin of the branch node add switch on int and add a few pins to it. Select the selection pin and drag it onto the function node at the start. From 0 pin of the switch on int add child actor component. From details tab choose your obstacle blueprint, duplicate the node and connect the duplicate node to pin 1, also change the blueprint class in the duplicated node to a different one. Now, select the relative transform pin of any one add child actor component and drag it onto the function node at start. Add a reroute node and connect the reroute node to another relative transform pin like I did here. Now, as runner game mode add set floor count for obstacles and connect both add child actor component nodes to set floor count for obstacles. Keep the value to 0. Compile and save. Now open spawn obstacles function, go to switch on in node and add a few pins to it, drag and drop the spawn moving obstacles function onto those pins. Connect the make relative transform return value to relative transform pin of the moving obstacle function. Now, change the selection value to 1 on any of the spawn moving obstacle function, change the max value of the random integer in range node connected to switch on in to the number of pins the switch on in has. Compile and save. Go to the level and press play. Once the player overlaps the box collision of the obstacle starts moving towards the player. You can increase or decrease the speed of the moving obstacle from the timeline node. Here, I forgot to record the part where I've added a vehicle sound that I have downloaded, but I have mentioned it before at the timestamp shown on the screen. If you want the sound that I have used, you can download it from the link in description. Now, I'm also creating two stationary vehicle obstacles. This is optional, so you don't have to do this. In obstacle folder in the content browser, select bp_obstacle_wall and duplicate it. Rename the duplicate bp_car1_stationary, open it. Go to the viewport and replace the static mesh from box to vehicle from the drop-down and details tab. Set the scale to 1.1 in all axes and rotate to 180 degrees in z-axis. Finally, adjust the size of the box collision. I'm creating another obstacle the same way. Once you are done with creating the stationary obstacles, go to bp_floor and open spawn moving obstacle function. Duplicate the switch on end node and connect it to the false pin of branch node. Also duplicate the add child actor component nodes and connect switch on in 0 and 1 pins to the add child actor component nodes. From the reroute node of relative transform pin, connect them to the duplicated add child actor component relative transform pins. Also, add a reroute node to the selection pin and connect the reroute node to the duplicated switch on in selection pin. Finally, select the duplicated Add Child Actor Component node and in Details tab change the class to the stationary obstacle you've created. Do the same for the other Add Child Actor Component node. Compile and save. Now, go to the level and press play. Now you can see the stationary vehicles also spawn on the level like other obstacles. And that's it for today's video. I hope you found this tutorial helpful. If you encounter any errors or need assistance, feel free to contact me via email or Discord. You can find the details in the description. If you enjoyed the video, please give it a thumbs up and subscribe to my channel for more tutorials. Thank you for watching, and I'll see you in the next one.